Oh, really now?
What happened?
No, nothing happened. I'm just looking at the mini map. Ah, I don't know what just happened. No, I didn't want to do that.
Boy, this wormhole sure is long. You're heading for Prilix, Preluia X, Y, dash 9, or dash H.
Yeah, man, I could. There's no way.
Prilua?
I don't know. My tongue just had a spasm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This fucking wormhole, man. Get the fuck out of it.
But yeah, I, looking at their itinerary was the, other thing. Whoa.
Gonna pull up a face cam?
Don't you wish?
Good lord, finally came out of that thing. What the hell is this thing?
So we did all of those, and now we're into this, the Norma Expanse. The Gray Fio is my target, basically.
You ever figure out how to make your own faction and start colonizing?
Oh no, but, excuse me. It kinda can be done from what I'm to understand. I don't know about colonization, but
setting up a base or something?
Yeah, like I wanna say it kinda can be done.
I'll Google it real quick.
Because now, from the looks of it, that puts me. Because they're only in waypoint 2. They're heading, like. This Friday, they'll be at waypoint 2. So it puts me 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 weeks, roughly, ahead of the group. Possibly. If I can get through the core, I want to see the amethyst cloud. I want to see the this Drano stellar, and I want to see the green crystal. Those are the only three places that I definitely want to see. And then my goal is to get to the last stop for the last 10,000 light years. The r Roncevua. 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 I don't know. I can't pronounce it. Because once I get there, that's the last place, essentially, that I can farm materials for Jumptonium. Jumponium. And, whatnots. And then I'll have 15,000 light more. Yeah, the last like day would be traveling from that farm spot to Beagle's Point. And then once I get there, it's gonna be, jeez, at least a week to get back. So the Greyfriars Stellar Forge is essentially what I'm shooting for.
I am back.
Hey, where you been?
Let's do stuff.
It's always
Adult
fun.
stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, Red just went 40,000 light years and traded in his ship.
40,000 light years?
Or, you know,
40.
rephrase, 40 light years.
40,000 light years? What'd you get?
Heal back.
A keel bag.
Yeah.
Why?
Max said the same thing.
Why?
For its cargo space. Deep cargo space.
See, you should've went with the Asp Explorer.
Shoulda. Coulda, woulda.
Okay, this monitor's got, five
This.
internal compartments. One of them's a five, the rest are threes. One, two.
He's got two fives, two fours, a three.
But it's a keel bag.
Yeah. And the place I bought it had absolutely zero upgrades. So I'm coming. I'm actually just made it to your terminal. I'm gonna upgrade, and then I'm gonna go do some smuggling. And I'm also trying to figure out how we can create our own faction. So we can colonize. I know Mac wants to put a gas station in the middle of the galaxy.
That's right. That's right. I'm telling you, it's if somebody can do, like, if you can set up a main hub at a halfway point, you're golden.
Yeah, if you can get a halfway point to like the center of the universe,
or to
yeah,
just like the next launching step, like a halfway to a halfway to a halfway, and just keep extending it out somehow, your colonization. Yeah, you'd be.
I'll be the designated smuggler. Something smuggled, I got it.
Got it under control.
Yeah, I don't care who does what as long as I can control the money.
Yeah, about that.
Understood, Zodi, understood. But I promise it won't all go to prostitutes and drugs. I will save some for you guys' salary.
Well, I don't know. If somebody has to control the money, I'm not sure who would have to do that, because we can't let Dolby do it. Because nobody would ever get
nobody
any money.
Nobody would see
it.
Anything, yep.
You already know.
Look, I need 5 mil to buy it.
Nope.
You've been through tougher times. You could go grind up 5 mil. Dolby, I'll swim across the lake and...
Don't make me catch a flight.
And find you... and hurt you badly. I'm not gonna beg you for the give me my money. No, I think it would be really neat though if because I would just like to, because what it is an open play. I'd like to find a spot that we could base our operations out of.
Right.
I'm thinking as soon as I can, I'm going to have a base of operations. It's just going to be Seoul.
Yeah, I agree.
But this
just because.
No! Too many. Too many people. I want to play an open play, but here's the thing. So we have to decide if we're going to have morals. I mean, and it can always fluctuate. But there is going to come a point in time where... I mean, it's like DayZ. If we go into open play, it's just like being in a regular public game. There is nothing to say that the guy who just warped into our system was a scout for 5 Corvettes with, you know, Fertilances as their fighter escort. You know what I'm saying? Like, we could very well be very little fish in a very, very big pond. And I'm okay with that. And that's why I was thinking we take something that's uber cheap if we die. Because then it's like, dude, I don't mind dying 5 or 6 times in a night because it only cost me like 150 or 200K. If we take like eagles... You know, we have our main rides. Right. We jump out to the system that we're operating out of. Cause
I'm
what
an
I'd,
eagle?
Yeah, basically, I'd like to scout a system in private where we can basically hop in and switch over from private to open play. You know, get over to that system in private, switch over to open play. Everybody buy El Cheapo Eagles and deck them out to the nines, and we, you know... And then we just go troll around in those in open play. Because who cares at 10K a piece? 10K if I die in an eagle. Okay. Like, I don't have the bankroll to throw million. I see guys with hundreds of millions of credits in cash, and I'm just like, I can't fathom having that much money to just throw away. Like, I'm, you know. So for the small potatoes that we're working with, I think that would be... Because in open play, you know we're just going to be FSD interdicting people, and everybody's set on wingman navlock, so when one of us drops, all of us drop. And we just go to straight rape face.
Yep, first time we do it, it's going to be 4 eagles, and we're going to pull out, like, a fucking Corvette or some shit. You're like, uh-oh.
Hey, man, it'll make for a good fight. It'll be a good laugh if we do knock it down, that's for sure. Could you imagine how frustrating that would have to be?
Yeah. I mean, you're talking, was it, 187 million?
Yeah, have like, a quarter of a $1 billion ride, and a group of clowns come pull you out. Like, it's a little tiny clown. How many clowns are getting out of that car? Oh my god. There's just so many. Oh wow, they're winning. This isn't good. I'd be really upset. But at that point, we're part of the problem and not part of the solution. But the whole, but I'm gonna be honest, the whole like, let's go and be heroes. Yeah, we'll do that when, no, listen, I'll do that when it's a coordinated effort with a lot of people. I'm not, we will be heroes. No. No.
Just no.
I, like, I'll die for you guys, but that's about it. But I want to go start randomly interacting with players in open, and I figured if we would wing up and some Eagles or El Cheapos, you know, the Viper Mark III is relatively cheap. We could afford to throw two or three of those away. We might just randomly meet people to have fun with, like, you know, a whole bunch of people not looking for any trouble. We might meet a whole bunch of people looking for trouble. Who knows? If I was a little more retarded, I would do some of this journey in open. But no, I'm not gonna do that to myself. Funny thing is there's three Gray Fio, Gray Fio nebulas, and I've got a guess as to which one it is that they're gonna be going to.
Oh, nice.
And you would like to think that because they're named the same names, they'd be relatively close to one another.
Nope. Nah, probably not.
And by probably not, as in like 3 to 5,000 light years apart.
Yeah, as in there's no way Mac's gonna be that lucky.
Nope. I think I got the right one because they say that there's another system that they jump to go take a look-see that's a cut that's real close, and when I was looking at the other two, this one's the only one that's got a nebula that's relatively close to it. And they're both pretty. This other nebula looks really pretty. It's red with some green and some orange and yellows. But the red and green looks really good. So I'm thinking that that's the. I just don't know. I'm gonna go AFK, go burn a Lucy, and troll the forums real quick and see if I can find anything. Because I'd like to cover this ground tonight. Before I got to take my daughter to school in the morning. And if it's a 5 hour trip and it's almost midnight, roughly, my goal is to be here in the Gray Fryo, whatever, by like 6 o'clock in the morning. And adding another 8,000 light years will put me right over the 15,000 light years away from Sol. So that's kind of cool. 'Cause I'm at
That is
just
out
over,
there.
yeah, I'm at over just over 9 or right around 9,000 right now. So like almost in the 10K club. Which, to be honest, it's not really like the f it's funny. The first 1,000 light years, I was super paranoid. The next 3,000 light years after that, it kinda, I was paranoid, but I was kinda like, eh, this being paranoid sucks. I just want to get this over with because I was jumping in economical. Then after
Okay.
that, yeah, then after that, I kinda forced myself to go into fastest, looked up real quick what stars are scoopable and which ones weren't, found and actually found a real nice write-up just about a whole bunch of general information. And then now, you know, 1,000 light years is about, it takes about a half hour to 45 minutes to go 1,000 light years. Maybe
All
a
right,
little
Mac, here you
longer.
go. Here's your minor faction. You have to. We're now accepting submissions for groups to establish their own minor faction in game.
Okay, you found it.
In order to apply for one registered on our groups list, you have to, basically message the devs.
Okay, and that's it?
It's a. Yeah, hold on. This is a big long paragraph, so I'm just explaining it to you. And it has a little resume type thing. It says name of group, name of minor faction, type of group, which is like democracy, criminal,
Right.
description, a location, and an allegiance.
Okay.
And it
And
says
that's
under
it?
that, nope. And then it says under that, for those who are already adopted, nope. Okay. All minor factions will be checked by the dev team to make sure they are suitable to be added into the game, and existing adopted minor factions will also be checked. And dev team's decisions will be final, and then one. You will only be available to have one official minor faction. Eventually, this will lead to the possibility of your faction becoming a power, and so it's really important that you grow and develop your faction ready for when that opportunity becomes available. It has a question and answer list as well.
Yeah, but basically, if you want one, they'll give you one, is what I take away from that. Now, whether it grows, sustains, thrives, or
They
shrivels
give
up
no
and
fucks.
dies, yeah, it's entirely up to you, and they care none, yeah. All right, but that's, yeah, it's, I mean, you guys know we're never gonna be, like, we don't even have the manpower to run one of those starports. Like
Oh no.
we'll be a 2-hut colony on a moon on in the middle of the system. But yeah, while you guys have nothing to do, start looking for stuff. All right, here's the thing. You know how to look in the power play map?
Yeah.
Look in the power play map and you'll see the bubble of all of the controlled areas, and then you have to imagine a bubble, an invisible bubble surrounding that whole power play map. Because let's say 500 light years in any direction away from one of those last outpost controlled areas, let's say a boundary of about 500 light years. Find something about that far away from civilization on the edge, on the fringes out there. Because guys who are doing relatively close exploration are at about the 1,000 light years to 500 light year mark. If we wanted to go out to 1,000 light years, we can. If we want to go back to civilization, we can. We're right in the middle of that buffer zone.
Here, right here, it says, somebody asked a question, where can we set up shop system-wise? Can we inhabit a system outside the current inhabited human space and colonize planets and become a power that way? Would there be repercussions for doing so? And the answer was, needs to be inhabited system already. That could be one far out, but would make it very difficult to expand as expansion requires a system to be populated. Would advise picking a system within the bubble.
All right, pick one that's got a super high super high population, but that's on the very, very outskirt fringes of the bubble. And you have to make a decision now whether you want to go close to the center or out away from the center. But other than that, you guys will have to look around. Ooh, ah, that just That just tickles me in so many ways. All right, I'm gonna AFK for a minute.
Aye.
My brain's just like, there's so many ideas bouncing around. And it's just for funsies, obviously. It's not like I wanna make this game a job or like, let's do this hardcore. No. But it'd be really, really cool to have our own place out in the middle of nowhere, right on the edge of the bubble.
Gas station.
Well, no, not for the gas station, but just 'cause that's our
That'll be
spot.
ours.
Yeah, find
Our
one with a
spot.
view. That's all I can say.
Right?
Find one with a view and yeah, that'll be nice 'cause in that way I know if I ever want to like go tool around, I can always just go back to this spot, you know. And if you guys are out tooling around and it's like, "Oh, I'm logging in now. Yeah, give me about 20 minutes and I'll be home." All right, cool. I'm gonna go do something, and then I'll meet you at home too, and then we can all rally at the same spot. I could park my ASP Explorer there after I hit the 65K light year club and cash these in. I'm parking this Explorer exactly the way it is, and I'm leaving it, kind of like you park your car in a garage and cover it. I'm gonna park this Explorer and leave it for nostalgic reasons. Just because I can. No, that'd be pretty silly. Tempting. I'd have to be like ludicrous rich after selling cartographs. All right, I'll be right back.
Right.
I can't wait to smuggle some shit. I just decked this thing out.
Did you?
Yeah.
Pretty cheap, huh?
Yeah, 3 mil.
No, I
Cost
meant
more.
pretty cheap outfit for your purposes.
Well, for my purposes, yeah, I didn't really full. I could have fully done it and be broke as fuck, but I kind of went a little cheaper on the parts.
Gotcha.
Kept it real. Rebuy cost right now is 255.
No, that's not bad at all.
Yeah. If I could just do one mission that's worth 400,000 and I get my ship scanned, you know. Nice.
Right.
I've already been there today and I didn't even get out of the terminal, got fined and remember?
That's pretty. Yeah, that's pretty damn funny.
I do like this joystick though. It's just different. I like it.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I just realized something.
What?
Is that if we do get a city going or something, or a starport, Mac's gonna want some trees.
Yep.
I'm at the Cal City. Cal
Oh,
City.
okay.
I was looking for a mission to do. None of them were at that terminal you're at. Oh, fuck.
What?
Forgot to request docking.
No.
I got all the way to the entrance and I was like, oh shit. Nice. I didn't realize it was bigger pads for bigger ships. Does it make sense now?
What's that?
I didn't realize it was big, giant pads for bigger ships.
Yeah.
I realized that.
played a spot of aces high earlier today.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. Nothing changes. The minute you get
no.
behind somebody, they run as hard as they can.
Yeah.
Eh. See, it wouldn't be so bad if I didn't, like, I can't help that I get behind somebody after the second turn, and it's no fun. It just, I'm serious, it sucks, actually. There was a spot about a year and a half ago, where everything was a good fight, you know? Now it's like two turns, I'm behind them, oh look, time for you to run away, bye.
Well, that's, yeah, your skill level was about on par with theirs.
Right. And I'm not saying I'm good, because I'm not, you know?
Oh, no, I mean, it doesn't have anything to do with being good. It's the average
the
main
average,
player
yeah.
is not good.
Not good, yeah. Like, and I didn't, and it was nice, because I could really, yes, everything was a fun fight. Yay, I get, now it's like, really? Did you not think that was going to be the outcome? What in your right mind made you think that turning down and away would make it more difficult for me to, you know?
Right.
Are you really flat turning? Oh, you poor nub. Well, that's one way to merge. I give you that.
Oh, you want to fuck them up? The main arena? If you actually manage to get a Guns Cold merge with somebody, throw a Chandelle.
Oh,
we're talking about throwing them the fuck off? They're like, hey?
Well, the Dolby showed me all about that. And the funny thing is I very rarely see somebody even give me a pure vertical merge anymore. Like, that's just a rarity. You know, somebody that's going to want an energy fight that goes straight to the vertical because they just want to be on top. I don't even get that anymore.
But you know the one maneuver that had people call me more names than anything else?
What's this?
Was B and Zers, right? They come down hard on your six. Like, coming down hard, right?
Yeah.
Flat turn left, pull real tight, and then roll.
Yeah.
Back to the right, over the top. So, basically, you're inverted right in their flight path, and then just pull up right in front of your guns.
Pull it up, yep.
And they're like, oh, that's bullshit, huh? Yeah. Fire your warp drive. How'd you stay on my ass 800 out when I was so much faster than you? I didn't.
I just never sank down as low as you thought I did. Yeah.
It just didn't keep turning. It broke my turn.
Yeah. The turn you thought was a whole turn that whole time wasn't a whole turn, dummy.
It was about a quarter turn, and then I just rolled over the top of you. I just let you fly underneath me is basically what happened.
Yeah, it's funny though because, like, my tracking is so much. That Spit 16 is so dirty. It's so dirty.
You know how I suck in that thing? Like, I cannot die all the fucking time in that thing.
It is.
I just cannot fly it. For whatever reason, that plane does not like me. Spit 5, Spit 9, I can fly those all
day. Oh, God. Yes. It's not even. It's just that plane, like, the way I like to fight suits that plane very, very well. Same with, like, the KI-84. Oh, I gotta get back. I gotta get on a Kai tour starting in February. I think that's what I'll get back in. But see, the Kai is more fragile.
Yeah. But it's got those flaps though, man.
Mm-hmm. And that real high alpha spiraling climb. Yep.
You get slow in that thing, man. Those flaps.
Oh yeah, I can turn with zeros almost. FM2s.
I mean, those are like F4U flaps. I mean, those things are monsters.
What I really like about the KI-84 that I'm going to have to start doing is, did Dolby ever introduce you to the game of chicken?
Fuel scooping. Yep.
I'm going to have to... Alright, so... You're in a flat scissor with somebody, right? And as the scissor progresses, both of you are slamming on the brakes to try and get the other guy to overshoot.
Right.
And ultimately what happens is you wind up side by side or one above the other kind of deal. But you...
Uh-huh.
And both of you are going the same speed as slow as you can. And it's a game of chicken to see who can go the slowest and get behind the other guy. Because now you're both going just over 75, 80 miles an hour. You cannot get any slower. So at that point, it's just maintaining that stall buffer. You know what I mean? The game of chicken.
Right.
So Dolby got me into that, introduced me into that.
No, I've never specifically tried to do that, but I've done that.
Yeah, it happens just naturally or organically in combat.
Even the... I mean, you spend a lot of time in the DA with Dolby.
Yeah.
You know who'll infuriate you in the dueling arena?
Hmm.
I don't know if you've ever been with him.
Who's this?
Krabby.
Oh, yeah, no, no, I've spent more time with Krabby than I have with Dolby.
That motherfucker will infuriate you.
No, I don't know about you, but I can shoot the Krabby down. He is very, who do you think I learned a lot of my defensive stuff from? Dolby and Krabby.
No, I used to be able to, but,
Yeah. Trust
the
me.
The one I never shot down one time. Scooping. Get back, shot him down one time in the dueling arena. Was Red Bull.
Oh, wow, that's a good kill. I've shot Krabby down. I've never killed Dolby.
I've killed Dolby quite a bit.
It's the mystery. It's funny too, because Dolby and I both giggle about it to this day. Dolby and I do not understand why I'm able to, because he's like, dude, you've killed better players than me. Why is it you can't shoot me down? And I'm like, honestly, I don't know. It might be something to do with the Senpai Kohai. It might, I don't know. I just cannot seem to.
Yeah, and the dueling arena, I mean, when I played all the time and I was in the dueling arena a lot, I could hold my own with pretty decent players, but...
Yeah, now I'm not saying
2 years of barely playing? Nah.
Yeah, I'm on the outs, too.
They'll fucking annihilate me.
Yeah, I hear you. I'm on the outs, too. But, yeah, there was this point a while ago where it was good. Now it's like, really... I wish it was back to where I was the bottom of the barrel, where I was one of the worst pilots in the game.
User in your channel timed out.
Uh-oh. Red died.
Red, no. I genuinely wish that was the case. Because it was good. I was a student, constantly.
There's always something to learn.
Mm-hmm.
From a fight.
Yep. And they were always enjoyable because win, lose, or draw, I did always get something out, you know? Like, even if it was just a... Yeah, it was just... The next aha moment was right around the corner for me. Now the aha moments are so few and far in between. And then while I'm fighting somebody, I'm talking to myself, you know... Man, I could help this guy. Let me just fly wing with him instead of shooting at him. And start playing with my food. I'm just following him around now. Just watching him panic. Could have shot him like 3, 4, 5 times already, but haven't pulled the trigger at all just because I want to watch him panic. and then accidentally overshoot and get killed.
Right.
That's happened a couple times, not gonna lie.
You know who used to do that? I don't know if you ever flew with him. He was a Muppet. And he would go on the, out in the K4, and he would be near an enemy base, just on the deck. Just slow on the deck. And he used to murder people. Agent 360?
Oh, I know that name. Never had the chance to fly with him or against him. The only Muppets I ever knew were Bunnies and Kappa and
Bunnies.
Ink. Those were the only ones that...
Miss Bunnies.
Mm-hmm.
And Latrobe.
Well, I know who Trobe is, I know who Joachim is, I know who Red Bull is, but I don't know them. Like, I know Voodoo Vince, Voodoo 15.
Oh, you never really flew with Red Bull, right?
Yeah, never had a chance to fly with him.
That dude's a beast.
Yeah. I've always wanted to be a little understudy of those guys, but never really... Once I got under Dolby's wing, that was kind of it for me. Like, our flight styles, once we got the...
Fuel scooping.
The jelly down, basically. Our flight styles complemented each other. He won't say so. I think so.
Of course he won't.
And he is a good teacher, despite what he says. You just have to be able to be self-taught and not be spoon-fed. That's the difference with Dolby.
Actually, the one who I learned the most from in the V8 early on was Krabby.
Yeah, Krabby's who I learned the most
same
from.
Way. He figured out.
Yeah.
Okay, how did I do that? Fuck, I don't know!
Fuel scooping complete.
Yeah, Krabby... Once I figured out, not necessarily how he was doing what he was doing, but I started to get, like, the concepts down.
The biggest thing with Krabby is he can manage his E.
Yeah... Like, that's... Krabby's the one who showed me that energy fighting is really the way to go. Dolby helped me, because there's been times in the merge with Dolby, like, he helped me understand that that's really, if you can master that, that's really the, but it's a balance between the both, is what Dolby always, tried to press. And then, but the thing with me, though, is I don't have the discipline to energy fight. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I tend to get too slow and try to angle fight. So my energy fighting turns into an angle fight.
Yeah, I always wind up sacrificing energy for angles. That's what I always do. And my problem is... I don't know how to explain it. I like to play with my food. As simplistic as it sounds, I get behind somebody relatively easily, have a cold, hard, quick squeeze of the trigger and the guy goes poof, and I'll just sit there and kind of giggle inside like, wow, that was... Come on, man, that was too easy. I can't. It's like picking on kids. Let me just follow this guy. Let me just fly wing with him.
User in your channel timed out.
Oh, bye, Zodi. So that's the floor. Yeah, that's where I'm going. It's
User entered your channel.
Hi, Zodi.
All right.
You know what the real funny part about playing with your food is? inevitably, the guys always wind up.
Yes.
No. Well, that does happen, yes, but inevitably, the person you're following just winds up flying straight to get away.
Yeah.
And when they do that, I can't shoot for fucking shit. I cannot hit a straight moving level flying target for the fucking life of me, dude. I hate it. I have to be like 200 off.
You know what? If somebody is flying straight and level away from me, you know what I can't hit them with? The fucking K4. If I'm in a K4, fuck it.
Oh, yeah. Nope. I'm here.
If I can't get them to turn, fuck it. I can't hit them.
You know what I wind up doing in the K4, believe it or not? I've ran into the back of people before I've shot them down and have killed them. I swear to God, I've done that before a couple times. Like, really? I was, you know, zoomed all the way in, not paying attention, and come on, just get, stop wiggling. Oh, that's my aircraft wiggling. Stop flying straight. You have collided. What? I just ran into the back of the guy and killed myself. Great.
Perfect.
If there was ever a time to rage quit, no. Funny though.
Oh yeah. I love the K4. Jesus.
K4 took a long time. The one
drive, you fucking nuts.
Dolby nailed it with the 109 Emil. If you can shoot the Emil, you can shoot the K4. Ballistic trajectories are almost identical with the speed and the lob on the 20 mils of the 109E.
User joined your channel.
Welcome, user.
Hola.
I'm back.
Yes.
Peter has problems.
I got
you. Pooing itself.
It's pooing itself?
Cooling, and yes, it's pooing.
It's pooing because it can't cool.
Yeah.
What is it that's overheating? Your CPU or your graphics cards?
It's CPU.
You need to get a better heatsink.
Yes.
Fuel scooping.
If you're really brave, in the middle of the night, you're gonna need two tubes of thermal paste and some screwdrivers and a little flashlight. You go pull the heatsink off your dad's computer, put it on yours, put yours on his. No one's the wiser.
Back.
What's that?
Back. Oh, I didn't mean to say your name. I meant the actual computer, Mac. I'm Mac.
Oh, one of you has a Mac and one doesn't? One of you has a Windows-based system? Oh, well. And somebody's boned.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
This guy. It only happens though when I got the heater running in my room and the computer on at the same time. No.
Do you have pretty good airflow to the computer? Is that, I mean, as silly as it sounds, that might be an issue. Like, do you have the fans set up right?
I've got two, one on the back top and one on the bottom front.
Well, that's something you could ask your old man to invest in, because they're like $2 to $4 for little cheapo fans that are LED based if you want it even, but no, cheap fans are like 99 cents at CompUSA or Best Buy or whatever. Buy a couple more fans for your computer, because what you need is a volume of air moving through your case. X amount of volume will keep the system at X temperature.
Right.
And then you just have to have it. So, I want to say if they're on top or the sides, they're pulling in. And if it's on the back panel where everything plugs into, it's blowing out. So, and it's what's called a positive like, there's different ways to set up different configurations. A negative setup means it's everything is blowing air all the way out through it. A positive setup is something where everything is blowing air all the way in, and it's forcing the heat out the bottom or out vents on one side. You see what I'm saying? Like, it just all depends.
Yeah, it seems like at the moment the one in the front is sucking in, the one in the back is blowing out.
Right, like there's usually a good setup, because what that does is allows airflow to constantly be flowing over the boards, etc.
Right.
So.
I only came back to finish this mission because I was at the planet, just dropped out of orbital cruise, and then my computer shuts off.
Oh, that's rough.
Uh-huh. Thirty kilometers away. Not as bad though as being out in bumfuck Egypt, 30,000 light years away from everything, and your computer shutting off and then resetting you.
That happened to me. That happened to me last night. I literally started my stream, was like 10 or 15 minutes into it or something like that, and then we had a huge power surge here in the neighborhood that killed the power for about 20 minutes. I honestly was freaking out simply because was I facing a star and scooping? Was I facing my next waypoint and about to be in hyperdrive? Was I in the map? What was I doing before? I don't know. But if I'm dead when I come back, I'm gonna choke out a little furry animal.
Right.
The fuzzier, the better. I was gonna lose my mind. I don't know what I would've done.
Would not have been good for something.
Yeah, it was nerve-wracking though. For a hot minute there, it really had me sweating.
Fuel scooping.
Also had a little Adobe update too. A little Adobe flash drive, flash player or whatever. But it said, increases video in something of performance. I'm like, oh, yep, I'll take that.
Give it to me.
give me a performance. Oh, there's a mission from this outpost and it says rapid transit. So I click on it. What am I hauling? I'm hauling 6 beers.
Somebody needs a 6-pack in a hurry.
Hold on, I'm gonna screenshot this one. Hold on.
That's nice. Yeah, I like that.
To an outpost. I'm hauling it to an outpost.
Because we're in a hurry.
They're willing to pay 140,000 credits. A 6-pack.
That'll guarantee to get you a 6-pack, yep.
I'll take it just for the hell of it. There's nothing other else here, so. Sadly, it doesn't give me any reputation.
Uh-oh. Let's see if this goes bad enough. I may have clicked the wrong button.
What happened?
I'm in a resource extraction, a crash, so I'm loading back in. I didn't want to click on private group and actually accidentally clicked open play.
Oh.
Oh.
That ought to be fun.
Yeah, for the 10 seconds I'm gonna be here.
Yeah, as you just spawn in, fucking hailstorm of lasers.
Out.
I'm out, fucking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. Give me my fucking line.
Yeah, the chances of somebody else being there is so slim to none.
Oh, yeah.
Mine didn't run too well about right before Matt got on, right before I got on this game again. Yeah, I ran in, I didn't see anybody for 5 hours.
And
two of those hours were on a high pop. I like looted for 3, and I was like, you know what? I kind of want to go player hunting. So I head off and I go on IPOP. Start at Northwest, go all the way to Electro. No, nothing but new spawns on the coast, like normal. Go to Kamishobo. I was following a new spawn, he was on the road. I was in the tree line following him. And I look in front of me and I see a guy. I'm like, oh shit, there's a guy right in front of me. And he's like legit 30 meters in front of me, crouch walking, staring at the same guy. I'm like, no shit. I got this AKM. I pull off the. I had a, found a BSS. I took off the scope, put it in my AKM. I took that off. And I started shooting at him. I saw two guys, so I started shooting at him. They start taking off down the hill. This thing is the fucking A coil M. That's what the K stands for. And it's fucking pouncing, pouncing. I hit this guy once out of like 30 shots. And then right behind me, like 2 feet, there's a third guy that I never saw shooting a Mosin point blank. And he can't hit me for his life. Then the second, I turn around, put a few into him, and he puts one into my chest with the, I had a plate carrier on, so that saved my life. Like it always does. But, I run off down the, tree line, because I'm bleeding, sit in the tree and bandage, and I just sit there. Like, there's no way they can know where I went. I mean, I dug through the valley and hit in a tree. Pew! Dead.
That's rough.
Well, that was short-lived. Here, Elite Dangerous, here I come.
Yeah.
Know that.
Oh, I gotta go buy the beer. That explains it. I got this thing.
Gotta go find it.
There's a website for it. I'm chill.
Oh yeah.
I am in what system? ESPFLF2. Right system.
Fuel sweeping complete.
I think I need to stop and retitle the broadcast. But not yet, I just got it. Because I'm out of NGC 6357 or whatever. NGC, NCG. I can't remember which one it was.
Don't tell me I can buy beer at that port I got it off from.
There we go.
I have to get a Wolf 25 to get beer, and I was still on economical, and it told me I needed 4 jumps to get there, and it looked like I could just go 1. I'm like, the fastest. Yep. First shot. What are you doing, Mac? Are you doing economical or are you doing fast?
Oh, I'm doing it in fastest, but I wind up micromanaging my jumps every 4 jumps.
Right.
I need to land on a scoopable star and do 125 light years every 4 jumps, roughly. So.
Math.
Are you watching? If you want to see how I do it, now would be a good time to watch for a hot second. Because it's the easiest way to, like, you watch it and you'll go, oh! And then you'll be a pro at exploring after this.
Roger, roger.
Like, I want to say not even a minute or two of watching and then you'll be pro. One more jump. Wow, the heat's awfully high.
Yeah, Akula figured out he's using the Vulture. He's got 2 giant laser beam. The beam lasers, lasers. And they overheat his system so much. But he figured out that, I got your stream open now. Out that if you get the heat sink launcher,
yep.
And you get it max how your heat you use that launcher. And yep. While it's draining your heat, you can just unload.
Yeah, you can hold constantly. The trigger down.
Yeah.
Alright, so this was the last jump I had into a system. There's a little delay.
Fuel scooping. Main fuel tank drained.
Jump into a system, I'll scan the main star, and I'll open up the system map. I'll look and see if there's anything worth scanning or landing on. The planets with the blue ring around them are planets you can land on. The planets without the blue ring are planets you can not land on. So there was nothing in that system worth landing on. I'll bump up my scoop now to about 200, 250. Just maintain my heat more than anything else at this point. So 125 light years is my target goal every 4 jumps. So the first thing I do is I go over to the view, I go to map, I go to now if you have it under none, show by color, star class, and then I deselect all of the class of stars that I cannot scoop from. So once I've done that, I'm just now looking for my route. Like I'm staring at this nebula here, the BLAA HYPA nebula, because that's kind of where I'm aiming at, if you will. So buck 12, buck 18, buck 20, buck 25. Yellow, orange stars, K's are what I prefer. Plot route, the orange line is solid all the way through because I know my total range is actually 140 plus light years. But I don't like to go my full range because I like to have a little bit left in the tank.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
So just watch this next segment here. So my heat, I gotta wait for my heat to drop down to below 40 before I can boost. If I don't, it overheats the engine, causes damage to the power plant, damage to your modules, blase blase. So heat being a factor. In between jumps. dangerous one. So my throttle's closed all the way. Scan it. That's scanning nothing in the system. Wait for that detailed scan to go through. And then this is where that, like, target next waypoint and system. Boom. Target next waypoint and system, and I'm off. Watch my heat. Under 40. Boosting up. We got 3 more jumps to my next scoop. Looking at fuel as well. I always keep an eye on my fuel because if I think I'm gonna be in trouble, I'll just scoop at the next scoopable star I come across. Sometimes you go all 4 jumps until the last jump where there's no scoopable stars, and that's where it really, if you aren't paying attention to where you're at as far as other stars around you, you'll get in big trouble. That guy is white hot. Doing 125 light years every 4 jumps, it takes me 8 cycles to hit 1,000 light years in total distance traveled. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So the shooting star method, this guy is hot. The shooting star method is you don't even stop and scan the planets like I'm doing and look in the system map. You literally, you jump in, you honk your frame shift, your scanner, and then you just go to the next one. They call that a shooting star. This, I want the detailed scans of the stars because I want to get some money out of it, so. And in the, so one more jump. Yeah, one more jump. You see how I have just a little bit left in my tank? That's only because I'm going 125 out of 140 light years total. That little bit left will allow me to jump 3, 5, 9 light years. If I have to use a booster to get 100% distance, I can jump out 10 light years to a scoopable star in case of emergency. You see what I'm saying?
Fuel scooping. Main fuel tank drained.
I'm looking for 200 a minute out of my fuel scoop. Alright, 200 a minute on my fuel scoop. Keeps my heat right under 60. Not a bad looking system. I always go for the reds, not the whites or the yellows or the blues, you know what I'm saying? The red stars always seem to be the, because they're the yellow, the K, yellow-orange stars. these stars that I'm facing. You see what I'm saying? Or did you stop watching? You're not even there.
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Five nebulas, I mean. That's kind of cool.
Tried to Fertiland.
Fertiland?
No, yeah, with two small beam lasers on them.
The Fertilands are nasty, man. If they could get guns on you, they're nasty.
Yeah.
Okay. Man, no, I just killed one. It took fucking forever. All I had was my two small beam lasers. Took forever. I'm not saying it was the best decision I've ever made, but it paid off.
Yeah, they do pay off, but
I don't mind them, really. I mean, they're not that big a deal. Anaconda.
Oh my
Anacondas.
God.
Just 10 half fucking turrets on the butt, on the back. Oh my god. Yeah, what?
I hit two different ships going into this landing place. I was speeding, so I got fine. I hit one outside of the hangar, and then another one while I was coming through the little mail slot. And it...
How'd you hit one outside?
I don't even know. I wasn't even looking. I was doing the downward thruster thingy. Where I was facing the mail slot, but I was coming downward from above it. It was weird. I didn't even see it coming. I got blindsided. It was stupid.
Oh, huh. That's probably what they said. I don't know where the hell that guy came from. He's all an ass. Son of a bitch.
Nice beer. Land enrichment system. Okay.
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Bottom 10 liquor, 10 wine, and a 6 thing of beer. But while I'm here, might as well buy something else and sell it.
Right. I will.
It's all profit in the end.
Mac, how do you have your joystick set up? Do you have it like, do you move your keyboard out of the way?
Yeah, I don't touch my keyboard. Very rarely do I need to.
Like, do you have it like Zodiac has it? Like, he's got his comes apart as well? You got the thruster on the left side of the keyboard and the joystick on the right?
Yeah, that's the way I have it, but I hardly ever touch my keyboard. But I have the keyboard in the center for typing and stuff, like, anything that I usually trim down all the fat. Anything that I have to touch during combat is what I have set. Everything else I can do. If I'm not in combat, then I have time to do whatever it is I'm doing. You see what I'm saying? It's when I'm in combat is when I can't stop to take my hands off the controls. And
yeah, I mean, yeah, I'm just wondering. Because I moved my keyboard to, like, front left of, like, my... Take it up with a joystick in front of me, and then my mouse on the right, and then front left. Out of the way, but still within reach, hit like landing. They're useless buttons.
Alright.
Okay, so, except for my shield generator, I have an A-rated ASP.
Oh, very nice. The shield generator is 15 mil...
16.
And the military bulkhead is 16 mil as well. Military grade bulkhead
Are
is like
sure?
retarded.
I think it's 5.
I don't know. I thought it was retarded expensive for the military.
No. Well, 5.9. The reactive is 15. The mirrored is 14. No, military's 6.
Oh, nice.
And I have 21 million in this thing.
Nice.
Well, 22 million.
So... when I see guys using the plasma accelerator, it's knocking off like 20% per hit.
Yeah.
It's insane. Cause I so can't wait to get back. Just simply so I can start testing different weapons. And not the boom boom variant, but with the boosted ammo.
Whoa, what is that?
What?
On your stream, that like dusty, like almost like cosmic looking stream of like.
That's the galaxy.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Never seen that.
Well, because it looks different the closer you get.
Oh, the center?
Yeah.
Oh. Who's got the wing going?
Good I question. Think I do.
Wow.
Yeah, I was thinking about swapping out my, you know, because I got the two medium and two small multi cannons. I was thinking about swapping out the small ones for maybe a cannon of some sort.
I was running the standard cannon instead of the multi cannons. And I found that, like, I couldn't find something I was happy with. Because I tried the fragmentation cannons. Those are garbage, by the way. You have to be saddled so hard on them. And then they hurt. But if there's any little bit of a distance, they don't do anything, really.
I could toss two railguns on there.
The railguns looked promising, except for they're not. They take a second to charge up. But squeeze, hold, trigger, 1/1000, 2, poo-hoo! You know, it's kind of.
And they are.
It's a water world. Let us see. It's a high metal content. Alright. That sure does look like a water world with a moon. Nice! Oops, not what I wanted to do. Alright, I got sidetracked here. On to the next.
Retarded and been muted. There's 11 resource extraction sites in this one system I'm in.
Damn.
There are about 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 hazardous, 1, 2 low, 2 normal, no high.
Huh.
And my the land, the place I gotta deliver the beer to does not exist.
Really?
Yeah.
You
it
sure?
Says land. It says land at a land at Port Conscac Silo, target port. That's the target port, and that does not exist.
Maybe check the system map and look at the planet maps.
Checked it earlier and there was no, it didn't even show any planets, but now that all these resource extraction sites came up, I'm kind of hoping that it'll come up with something. Probably because it's unexplored and stuff, and I sold my discovery scanner. I'll go buy another one.
That's probably why. May want to get a surface scanner.
If I can buy one at this little platform here.
No, the detailed surface scanner is only for exploring. When you do a normal, like when you look at a planet and it does the scanning, that's the class type 1 scan. The detailed surface scan does that same thing but gives you a type 2 scan or something like that. A type 2 or a type 3. I forget what it was I had read. But yeah, it's only for
and they must really want some beer. They don't even know where they at.
Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop Disengaged.
By that scanner here, but
engaged. Fuel scoop disengaged. Fuel scooping complete. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Shot at right before I land.
That's always fun.
And see, I didn't even get hit, I just got lasers flying past me.
Pew
what
pew. Somebody else in the docking bay is getting shot at. Completely random. Did you at least get the geist of everything that you needed to, Red?
Fuel scooping.
To haul?
No, what? For what I mean by using the map and jumping out your maximum distance and being able to always do that.
Oh yeah, yeah.
It doesn't matter what you're in and what you're flying, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you need to travel some distances, that's the way to do it.
Yeah.
Disengaged.
awesome. I'm transporting battle weapons and Imperial slaves. Go. To drop the slaves off first. So Mac, what do you think the whenever you get back from your adventure, we're gonna find a system and create a
Yeah, I hope so. That'd be nice. That'd be real nice. I'll be right back though.
Station I have to deliver slaves to is like, I'll have an outpost job, but this one's actually a hub, one of those like octagon, like dice shaped hubs, like just like the city. See, and I've got a different mission, not only this one, but I also have another mission that I gotta. Smuggle into this one, smuggle out, then smuggle into another one. I can't do it.
I can't do it.